First of all, a bit about BROEN. We have a history of 70 years. We have been developing and producing reliable valves for 70 years, mainly for water, air, and gas lines. We are part of Alberts in the Netherlands. We have a headquarter in Denmark, and we have five factories around the globe. So we have production in Denmark, Poland, Russia, and the U.S. We are 600 employees on three continents, and we have a yearly production of more than 3 million valves. Our gross turnover is more than 120 million euros. And the BROEN Group has four divisions: the BROEN Full Flow, BALLOFIX, BALLOMAX, and BROEN CLORIOS. BALLOFIX is for building industry, BALLOMAX is for district energy and gas, and BROEN CLORIOS is mainly for marine applications and power industry. The Full Flow is a new type of valve that we are introducing in more segments. But today we will speak about the trunnion mounted ball valve, and we have made a design that is modular, so it's easy to put down the modules together to get the design needed for your area. It's a compact design, and we have improved the stem guide, so it's easy to see if it's open or closed. All the certificates are available for pressure equipment directive and for pressure testing and for underground installation.
Yeah, so this is the parts of the new trunnion ball valve. And as you can see, this consists of a lot of parts, and all these parts can be combined into a valve. There we have, to the left, we have the housing, the stem guide, the isoflange. These are the welding ends, and all this combined, then we have the housing and also the welding ends. We also have three types of stem guides, the base. We also have the possibility of the valves for the DPB, or we have the bleeder valve or the bleeder function of the trunnion. All this combined, we can have a lot of different standards or models of the trunnion ball valve. But we have, together with our customers in different countries, created some standards. We have the basic model with the hexagon top, or the standard with the isoflange top, and then we also have what we call a Swedish model for the EN48 segment. Then we have the basic above ground trunnion valve, and also we have a German model and a French model. I will come back later in more detail for what the different types of standards are. The range of the new design model of BALLOMAX trunnion valve is DN200 to 350 mm reduced bore and DN150 to DN300 full bore. For the flange models, the pressure range is PN16, PN25, or PN40. For the welded end, it's only in PN40, because it's the same construction, whether it's PN16, PN25, or PN40, so we have the PN40 valve. The temperature range of the standard ball valve is -20 degrees to 150 degrees. We do, however, have an option where we can go up to 200 degrees.
That's mainly in the French version because they have a higher temperature on their district energy systems.
Yes, and we can have it in flanged or welding connections. And for the valves above ground, the valves are painted black. The valves can be used for district heating, but also for the cooling segment. So what does it mean, all this? We have the modular design. We which means that we have a better use of material of the valve. And with the better use of the material, we get a more compact design, which in the long run saves insulation material. The new construction or design of the stem guide, but also the trunnion bottom bearing, means that we have a lower torque of the valve. The lower torque means also that we can use smaller isoflanges, and with the lower torque also we can use smaller gearboxes. The new construction is not as heavy as it used to be, so it's easier to handle. This construction of the new ball valve is dedicated for district energy use. And we have developed new construction processes, which means that we have a better delivery time for this valve. And above all this, it's still a Ballomax trunnion ball valve. And this is what the new trunnion ball valve consists of. We have still at the top, we have shown the stem guide with a new design. And also in the bottom, we have the trunnion bearing, bottom bearing, which is also a new design. Otherwise, it's still the same material we're using, but we are just using it all in a better way, which means that we still have the ball, which is of carbon steel, but then it's nickel plated for a better and smoother surface. Here we have two tables showing that the table on the left was the torque that we had with the previous model. And to the right, we have the new table for the new trunnion ball valve. And the torques of the new trunnion is lower than before. 239, it was previous 388, which also means that we go from an isoflange F14 to an isoflange F12. And this means that we can use a smaller gearbox or actuator. This is the range. We have the reduced ball, DN200 up to DN350. And as I said, with the welding ends, we have the PN40 model. And for the flanged models, we have the PN16, 25 on PN40. We also have four models for the full ball. The range is DN150 up to DN300. And again, with the same pressure range, PN40, and for the flange, PN16, 25, and PN40. Now I will show you what the standard that we have created together with our customers in countries. And to start, we have the basic standard, the basic model. And this is the valve that is available in full bore and reduced bore, and also combined with the BROEN gear. You can have it as a welded end or the flanged end. But this basic model is without the base. It's without the DBB valve, but we still have the lead function of the trunnion. And for the basic standard, we are not able to move the bleeder valve or the DBB function. If you want to include the base or this DBB valve, then it's a non-standard, and this means another delivery time. The range for this basic model is DN150 up to DN1000. And above the range of this new design trunnion ball valve, we're using the current design of the trunnion valve. All these basic models are also available for the underground use as EN488 valves. Uh, in France, we had a customer, a lot of customers with special demands. One of them was the high pressure or high temperature up to the 200 degrees. This means that the customers have some requirements about the lockable the valves on this. So we have constructed this full bore valve for the French, as we call it, the French model. And for this, we have a valve with the base is included, because we have the valve for DBB. And this valve is lockable as a requirement from France. We can also use it with the BROEN gear or similar. The range for the French model is DN50 up to DN800. And the temperature is 200 degrees, because we're using AFLAS O-rings in the stem guide instead of the standard EPDM O-rings. And again, any changes for this standard will require a new delivery time. Then we also have a German model. And this model is created together with the customers we have in Germany. And what one of the requirements that they had was the wall thickness of the welding ends. The welding ends of this is more thick than the standard ball valve. So the German valve, German model, is a full bore valve with the welding ends, but also have a base with the valve for DBB. This valve is not lockable. The range of the German model is DN150 to DN600. And again, any changes for this will require a new delivery time. The last standard we have is what we call the Sweden model. And this is for the EN48 segment. The requirement from Swedish customers was that they are using a lot of hydraulic actuators. And in order to have the room for the actuators in the wells, they had to have a smaller stem guide. So we have decreased the height of the stem guides for the Swedish models. It's still, you can have it both as full bore and reduced bore, but the stem height is lower than the standard basic EN48 valve. The range for the Swedish models is DN150 to 1000. And again, any change for this will require a new delivery time. Even if you have called these the French or German or Swedish models, doesn't mean that the valves only can be sold in these countries. We can use it anywhere, so we can sell it. It's just to have some kind of a standard, so we have the quick delivery time of 6 weeks.
So some of a bit of summer up of all the different models. There is some advantages and some value propositions that I would like to mention for you once again. We are now down to a delivery time from 6 weeks, where it was from 8 to 10 weeks in average before. That means very competitive delivery times. We have 24 hours service, so it's for customers, it's always possible to get in touch with us. Due to the less torque in the new design, there's money to save by the installation of a smaller gearbox. Because of the compact design, you must use less insulation, if it's going to be insulated, of course. It's a lighter construction, then it's easier to install. So that's some of the points where you really achieve something about this new modular design. But the really big advantage is that you can have a fast delivery times using the models. And our production is set to handle this fast deliveries by choosing some of the fixed models. So a summary up, in the bottom you see some of the delivery times for sizes. up to 300 full bore, 350 reduced bore. It's 6 weeks. And between 500 full bore or 600 reduced bore, it's 7 weeks. And above that, we have 12 weeks delivery time. But up to DN 500 and 600 reduced bore, it's 7 weeks. And that's a really an improvement in our workshop compared to the 8 to 10 weeks in general. So we're really happy to show this to the market with all the advantages that we see in our valve.